Hey everyone, and welcome back. In this quick tip, I will show you how to override a parent page item in Adobe InDesign. As a reminder, parent pages are not a part of your page count. They are templates you can create and apply to pages in your document for repeated content like page numbers, headers, footers, and backgrounds. To access your parent pages, on the right side, you may see it in the side panels. If not, go to the window menu bar, scroll to pages, and click on that to open the pages panel. All right. So once you got your pages panel open, take a look. You'll see the top section displays all of your parent pages. These are your templates. Below that, in the bottom section, those are your actual document pages. Now here's something you'll notice. If you have content on your document page that came from a parent page, it's going to be locked. You won't be able to just click on it and edit directly from your document page. If you want to unlock this item for a one-off change, here's the trick. On a Mac, it's Command-Shift-Click on the item. For a PC user, that's Control-Shift-Click on the item. And there you go. It's unlocked. And now you can make your edits. Here is a super important thing to remember about overriding. When you do this, you're essentially telling InDesign, hey, this specific item on this page is now its own thing. It's no longer connected to that parent page. Let me show you what I mean. If I double-click back to our parent page here, and let's say I decide to change its header text. Now, when I double-click back to my document page, you'll see those changes didn't apply to the text box we overrode. It's disconnected now. But notice every other instance of this text box on pages we haven't touched is updated perfectly. But wait, what if you change your mind? What if you want to bring that parent page content back and override your override? You've got several ways to reapply your parent page content and get everything back in sync. The simple method is to drag your parent page directly onto your document page. Select the document page you're working on, right-click, and choose Apply Parent Pages to the specific page you need. Head to the Pages panel. Click the drop-down menu and select Apply Parent Pages to the specific page you need. Once you do this, you'll see that your item is back to its parent page default and it's reconnected. You won't be able to click on it directly from the document page anymore, but it will now update automatically with any changes you make on the parent page. And that's it. I hope you found this helpful. Please give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more tips and tricks. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next video.